go to photographsofdreams.com. I've included a link here in the show notes.
He's big and he plays football and he'll kick the out of you!
I'm scared. I'm shaking in my boots.
For the Garbage In, Garbage Out segment, we've got a few different things to talk about here this past week. One of the things that I would have liked to have talked about would be the fact that I was able to listen to Siddhartha at work. That's a Hermann Hesse novel that was written, Hermann Hesse, I think maybe that's how you pronounce it, I'm not sure. Yeah, I'm just not that good with names. Nor did I have good luck actually listening to this. It's a new, relatively new adaptation of the story. It's an Indian story or an allegory. And it describes a young prince's search for enlightenment. Well, I shouldn't say young prince because he starts out young, but he ages, obviously, as the story goes on. Along his travels, he meets the Buddha. And it's really just a great story. I don't pretend to be overly edumacated here, and I'm certainly not putting on airs. In fact, the thing that actually makes this worth listening to and enjoyable for me is the simple way the story is written. It does use a lot of phrases regarding the Indian faith and philosophy. But like I said, you can get past all of that, or if you've done a little bit of reading, you might be familiar with some of the philosophies that they talk about. But at any rate, it's a great book. I was disappointed when the second disc didn't work, so I didn't get a chance to finish that. But I have heard it before. I am familiar with the work and was looking forward to enjoying it again. Just didn't happen for me. Naturally, upon recording this, I can't find any of the notes that I made regarding the book. So maybe I'll save that for a discussion for another time once I've completed the entire book and it's fresh in my mind. I'll take those notes over again. One of the other things that I enjoyed was Prodigal Summer by Barbara Kingsolver. Not a book I would normally pick up. But that's the beauty of getting things on CD. You have the opportunity to hear and listen to stories that you normally wouldn't necessarily put the time into reading. This was something that my wife picked up, and while I wasn't able to enjoy the entire book from start to finish, I gotta say there was a lot of things in there about simple country life. Not that I missed, but they were certainly a reminder of the time that I grew up in Michigan, being raised by an older aunt, and just things like canning preserves and that type of stuff, you know, farming, gardening, some things of that nature. At any rate, it's another story that I enjoyed this past week, parts of it at any rate. The other thing was I was able to see Sherlock Holmes last night. Normally, I don't make it out to the movies, usually first-run movies, all that often, just because of, well, a few different reasons right now, finances being one of them. But aside from that, we made a point to go out with another friend and his girlfriend, and so the four of us went and saw Sherlock Holmes. Good movie. I'm surprised, well, how should I put this? Of course, I'm a big fan of all of the Sherlock Holmes stories, and even the radio dramas that they did from the 40s and 50s, the New Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. But aside from that, when I saw that it was a Guy Ritchie movie, I thought, okay, well, they're going to update the story. And from the previews, I mean, you see drinking, sex, and fighting, which none of which I'm opposed to. But for the Sherlock Holmes, I thought, well, you know, they're maybe going to update the story a little bit too much. He certainly had character flaws, amongst them doing cocaine, one of them. But they didn't cover that in the movie. Anyhow, so I thought they were going to dwell so long on his the negative aspects that maybe it was going to lose a bit of the story, you know, the elements that made it Sherlock Holmes. And it didn't. It maybe didn't have as much problem solving as I would have liked to have seen, but I think he did a great job updating it for a modern audience. All the performances were top-notch by everybody in there. They kind of took Irene Adler's character and made her into a little bit more than what she was in the initial stories or whatever. Like I said, that's just me. I'm into the books and stories. A modern audience isn't going to know that, and hopefully it'll get the kind of exposure or give exposure to a new group, a new audience for some of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's works. A couple of things that you may not be aware of, even if you are aware of the Sherlock Holmes stories, is Sir Arthur Conan Doyle actually solved, using his own deductive reasoning, solved a couple of cases of people that one, I believe, was on death row, if not both of them. And he was able to use his actual detective skills that he just wrote about, basically, to actually solve some crimes. So that was kind of cool. The tragic thing, of course, that going back to an earlier episode where I was talking about Houdini and having read The Secret Life of Houdini, you see how he went downhill and maybe didn't apply that deductive reasoning to the spirit mediums. One of who he, his second wife, I believe, was. And unfortunately, she took advantage of him and so on. Like I said, you check out the Houdini book and you can find out more about that. Kind of sad to think of him ending that way, but during the day, you know, during his prime, while he was writing Sherlock Holmes and stuff, he was definitely a sharp guy, and the world is definitely a better place for having him in it and having him write those stories. So I actually just finished recording the trick-or-treat segment, and wow, I yammered on for a really long time. So I'm going to cut the garbage in, garbage out short, and we're going to put this together and see how long the total length of this episode is going to be. I apologize for going so far over, but I hope you stayed with me for the full 30 minutes to kill and then some. So again, thanks for listening.